What's up, everybody up on YouTube? Thanks for dropping in for this segment of the Matrix Movie Edition with your boy Prime. I'm glad y'all can officially join me. And I'm going to talk about Batman versus Superman, the Ultimate Edition. And everyone, what I can tell you is that this is the version that should have been in the theaters in the first place. I don't understand why Warner Brothers did not... Well, actually, I do understand why they didn't want it, but... It's baffling that they did not put this version in the theaters from jump. So I'm not going to give nobody no spoilers or anything. I'm just going to give y'all my actual review of the Ultimate Edition and from my perspective. I'm going to come as a DC fan, but I'm going to give you a critic's point of view. Let me put it to you that way. Again, this movie should have been the movie that should have been out from the jump. From the parts that's going to put everything into perspective is that the movie is going to make sense in a lot of ways. You're going to feel a closeness to Kal-El, who is Superman. And you're going to understand the reason on why he has his reasons why he does not like Batman. You'll also have your reasons with Bruce, who is Batman. You'll have your reasons on why he don't like Kal, who is Superman. You will understand the reason why they do not like each other. Also, with Lex Luthor, you will actually see his character come out way more now. So you will understand his reasonings and everything a whole lot more. There's a key moment in the movie where they actually took this moment out between him and the senator. That's a key moment too. The moment in Africa, there's a lot of parts. I don't want to spoil it for everybody, but once you see it, and you know, the ones that really, really pay attention, because it's a serious movie. So with it being a serious movie, I like that, because it's not for kids. And I understand the reason why, you know, it's really for individuals that's like 13, 14 and up. It's not really for little kids. But they put some scenes in there that is not in there. There is some cussing. So they did put things in there that is not for children, and it is rated R. However, I understand the reason why they wanted to put it PG-13. Because they wanted to try to get children into the movie. And at the same time, you know, it's not really for that particular audience. Not for children that's real young. It's really for individuals that can really decipher this movie and that can really understand it. And if you're not a DC person, if you're a casual moviegoer and you're not really into the comic universe, there's a lot of things you're not going to understand from the original theater version. And I understand the reason why a lot of individuals didn't understand it. Me personally, I loved it, but I can see the reason why how individuals did not like the first theater version. When they finally watch the Ultimate Edition and y'all finally watch it, y'all really are going to enjoy it, because that 30 minutes of footage that they took out, wow, it's going to make a very, very big difference in the movie, because it's going to link everything up, and it's going to make a lot of sense to a lot of people. Me, I would say that now Ben Affleck is the true Batman. I mean, out of all the Batmans, he's the perfect Bruce Wayne. I cannot take that away from Ben Affleck. At first, I was skeptical when they first announced him to be Batman, but whoa, man, he did an amazing job. And at the same time, when it comes down to Henry Cavill, he's playing Superman, and you know, the scene with him and his moms and stuff like that. There's a lot of stuff that's in there, people. I'm not going to spoil it for you. All I can tell you is that it is very, very good. I give this a 9 out of 10. And the only reason why I give it a 9 out of 10 and I don't give it a 10 out of 10, because, like I said, they're trying to get Justice League and they're trying to get everything all together all at once. They try to get everything all in this movie, but it's a good 3 hours. And I mean, it's a very, very good 3 hours. You know, that's probably the only thing I'll probably say, because they try to get everything in 3 hours. They're just trying to get Justice League along. However, I feel that Suicide Squad is going to play a major part. In this as well. I think everything is going to happen before this, or it's going to be happening right at the same time Man of Steel was going on. So that's my suggestion and my speculation with that as well. However, y'all are not going to be disappointed with this movie. I mean, some of you, the ones that really, really dislike the movie, y'all probably still going to have a dislike towards the movie, even if you see it, you know. But if you are a person that really going to sit down, listen, be observant, put the pieces together, and understand the story and what they're trying to bring, you're going to enjoy the movie. All right, everybody, I'm about to get up on out of here. If you liked the video, please press that like button and subscribe to my channel. If you didn't like the movie, the video, please still like the video and subscribe to the channel. This your boy Prime. If you know, but if you didn't know, your boy Prime always going to bring it to you. All right, y'all, I'm out of here. Peace. Let's start again.